Well, turnout's been light. We had projected that we'd be somewhere between 28% and 32%. I still believe that we'll probably achieve that number, but the weather's been suspect in certain parts of the state today, and because of that, some people have probably changed their plans from voting early to voting later in the day. But of course, polls remain open in all 1,980 polling sites until 7 p.m. So we encourage our people to get to the polls, cast their ballot for the candidate of their choice.
And what do you think, I know in the past when you said that 28 to 32, you felt like there was gonna be higher than normal turnout. So what were you thinking would drive people to the polls this year?
Well, again, I feel like with the candidates that we have for governor and for the United States Senate and the very spirited campaigns from four gubernatorial candidates and three U.S. Senate candidates, that typically will generate a lot more interest. However, one of the things that's unusual about this midterm is that this time we only have the sheriff, we have some county commissioners, we have some school board races, but we don't have a lot of local races. Outside the district attorney and the legislature, you don't have any regional offices up. So it's a little different, but it's one that we expect to correct itself as the day continues.
As we get closer to the end of voting today and we start thinking about results coming in, do you think any kind of recent security changes will make those votes come in slower? Or how do you think that's going to
happen? We feel real confident in our process that we introduced back in 2016 with election night reporting. Now, one of the things that is different in 2022 than any other year we've ever experienced is that we now have these hardened, secure computers that we purchased for all 67 counties at a cost of almost $250,000. Now, in the past, all the counties have used one unit to transfer that information from their county seat to our office here in Montgomery, except for Jefferson. And in Jefferson, they've had five different locations that have received that data and then transmitted it to us. Now, because of the changes in the hardened computer, Jefferson County is the only county in the state that has two, but they feel like that might be a deterrent for them as far as reporting in a timely fashion, but time will see.
Okay. And I know this is your last term here. You have what, until January, right?
January 16th.
And what's your plans? Have you made those public?
Well, if I knew, I'd let you know. My wife is really more concerned than you are.
All right. Might we see you again in some kind of public official office?
Well, we're not sure what the future will hold. Of course, I'll be serving my second term until January the 16th of 2023, but we'll have to wait and see what opportunities may exist and whether or not public service is in my future, I'm not sure, but I certainly want to be where the Lord wants me to be and I want to be doing what He wants me to be doing to be impactful for Him and serving the state of Alabama.